welcome back to Child and Chill on Your. Now let's get straight into the news for today. Now Tesco is facing Britain's largest ever equal pay claim and possible bill running to £4 billion, bro. Now thousands of women who work in Tesco stores could receive a back pay totaling £20,000. Now if you don't know what I'm talking about, basically equal rights pay. Again, we've all heard about the BBC situation and various other situations. Now, Tesco has been caught for basically not paying a woman and a man equal just working in a store like a normal retail job. Now, lawyers say hourly paid female store staff earn less than men, which is what I was just telling you about. Now, a common pay an hourly for somebody working in a store for a woman is £8 and for a man is £11 an hour. So ladies and gentlemen, go check and see how much you are earning. You could be one of the possible victims to be getting a huge paycheck back from Tesco due to non-equal pay. Now let's go into the next story. Will Smith celebrates Jada Smith's 100 million Spotify stream in style. And he did this by recreating his iconic music video icon where he came out of the car. You know what, let me not just tie, man. Let's play the video right now.
What you call an icon living? Start a record label, Miss Fish just did it. Nylon, couple 5 minutes. Whoa, we are too hot in the business. About to make a movie independent. Need new trucks independent. I need you to listen to the vision. All your verses sound like dirty dishes. I'm about to clean them in the kitchen. I am just an icon living.
J Diggy, I'm proud of you, baby. 100 million streams. Congratulations, man. 100 million. Congrats. I love you.
Yeah, that was the video, man. It's dope. Shout out to Will Smith. Go follow him on Instagram, man. That's some great stuff in there as well. And let's get straight into the next story. Ever hired a BT worker? I mean, do you have any problems? Maybe your internet's not working? Or maybe your telephone has got issues? Well, potentially, you could end up like this.
Let me tell you straight, okay, right? Okay, you call me out in front of your friend, I'm blind. Yeah, I don't give a about you. Mind your mouth, brother. Tell your friend. No, I'm telling you.
Why trust in that?
But listen, when he brings and all the rest of your
guys, come on, bro.
What are you going to do? No, I'm telling you, man. You got a big mouth. Let me tell you something, bro. Shut up, man. You calm your mouth and the next one takes your face off. Come take your big man. Go on, take your face off. I offered you like a man. That's BT worker there, yeah? That's a BT staff. That's the sort of BT. That's random, isn't it? I mean, apparently the reason why that situation went down is because two kids, adults, I don't know their ages, walked on the road without necessarily looking and, you know, narrowly missed the van, and the guy got out and got really angry at them and, you know, they were just swearing at each other. That's crazy, man. But that's the end of the news for today. Yeah, very slow news day today, but I'll be back here in a second for the sports. And welcome back to Why I Did an Interview. Anyway, let's change to the sports. Produce Ebra to join West Ham after 3 months as a free agent. Now, if you didn't know why Produce Ebra wasn't playing at the moment, it's because the situation went down in Marseille where he happened to throw a kick. Hit somebody. Let's just say that due to some racial slurs from a fan, and you know, he got banned from Marseille, a contract got terminated, and he ended up being without a football club. Great character. I love his humour. He's a former Manchester United player as well. So Lovely to have you back, Patrice Evra. Let's grace some dope Instagram videos. You should go check him out. It's on Instagram. It's Instagram shout-outs today, isn't it? Next story. Swansea winning 8-1 against Notts County. Great, great FA Cup fourth round replay. I'm actually about to watch the game now because I haven't actually watched it. So, hey, let me not tell you too much about the game. But they will now go into the fifth round to play Sheffield Wednesday, which is Swansea's manager's former club, which he actually left in December, ironically. So it'll be dope to see how him going back will look like. Big shout out to Swansea. Looks like he's really turning it around. Swansea now out of the bottom three, moving forward, winning games, which is important, and scoring goals. If you know, people like Abraham, who's on loan from Chelsea, is now getting on the score sheet. Will he be able to bring back Renato Sanchez from his upsetting period at the moment? Which will be very exciting to find out. Now let's go into the next game that took place, which is Huddersfield 4, Birmingham 1. Another classic FA Cup fourth round match replay. Huddersfield is again, you know, they're kind of struggling in the Premier League. I think it's 1-10 or no win in 10, should I say. Possibly 1-10. I can't really remember the stats. But, you know, there's another situation there where players just aren't... I mean, to be fair, Huddersfield are a championship side. They made a couple of decent signings in Tom Ince, but Tom Ince has never really been a Premier League player. So for getting Huddersfield, it's great to get in the goals, get amongst the goals. They have now set up a fifth round match with Manchester United, my squad. So, yeah, they're going to get wrapped up anyway. Anyway, I'm quite happy to be playing Huddersfield. And what do you guys think? Comment in the section below what you think about all the sports, FA Cup situation. Do you think FA Cup is still worthy of a competition? I think a lot of people now are just speculating that the competition is lost its pride, should I say. But with all the top managers now technically playing their best team, you can look at Arsenal, because you know, now you have to win at least one trophy. Carling Cup's now becoming important. FA Cup's now becoming important. And obviously you've got the Premier League, Champions League. And yeah, what do you guys think? Also, next story for sports is incidents of racism, homophobia and other forms of discrimination has risen up by a staggering 38% compared to last year. That is huge, huge disappointment for all the Say No to Racism campaign. I personally think the issue, well, you've had the, is it the Britain's First, whatever that thing was with Tommy Robinson and Jada, or whatever that chick was, you know, when they went out and they were like saying no to Muslims or get rid of Muslims or whatever she was on about there. She lost that anyway. we all heard about, you know, sexual assault and all that claim came in. I was like, whoa, big deal. I thought you was fighting the games, but like, kind of losing. And then, you know, it's difficult, man. I think I had a big talk of racism before. I don't really want to get into it, but, homophobia as well, I think that's very unfortunate. People are humans, bro. Like, people are going to be different to what you cater it to be. Some people want to be a Muslim and live that way. Some people want to be a Hindu. Some people want to be a Christian. Some people don't even give a shit about any of it. It's just the way life goes. And I think it's weird to me that people just don't seem to get that. I mean, okay, cool, we have the ISIS and the jihads or whatever they are. And then we have the murderers and the gangs and whoever they are. And it's like, aight, cool. People do some bad shit. But come on, man. You can't cater this and that to a whole nation. Or a whole race, should I say. And it's just crazy that that's a thing. Like, come on, man. If people want to go and sleep. If a guy wants to sleep with another guy, if a girl wants to sleep with another girl. Ironically, though, if a girl sleeps with a girl, it's kind of cool and sexy. If a dude does it with another dude, it's not sexy. I'm tired, man. I'm tired of having this comment. I feel like this is something I'll talk about every single week. But anyway, you know what I'm saying? That's the end of the sport, man. Comment in the section below what you think about the whole discrimination situation rising up to 38%. In the Premier League, by the way. You know what I'm saying? And the EFL League. 38%. Oh, I forgot to read your stat. 111 cases since August. God damn. Come on, man. Like, you guys gotta stop. If you've got black players in your team, how can you be racist? To another player in a different team. Anyways, man, let's leave the conversation right here. Don't forget, I'll see you here tomorrow for more news and more sport. Peace, y'all. Peace. Me, I just moved to the next thing. Moved to the next thing.